And before that, you are also then in at your home, basically,
Yeah,
so.
I mean, I kind of have to have a thesis to write, and it didn't start at all, so I should
I know that
probably.
feeling. In the end, I
Yeah.
started it.
I mean, I wouldn't even care that much about it, but the problem is, I kind of want to get an A in it. Like, I want to ace it
Yeah,
because
for the time attack, yeah.
it's not really an important subject, but it's a subject I currently have an A, so. And it's not that difficult. It just takes time, and I just don't want to invest the time. Yeah. Is this a new map already? Yeah.
Yes, it is.
Something's wrong. Oh well. But yeah, I mean, I will eventually get down to it and just ride it, and
Wobei,
I'll
das
see
ist
about
technisch.
this. Oh, I remember this finish actually. Well, some kind of similar finish,
Yeah,
I
I
guess.
thought already. Huh? You know the map?
No, there was this one TD Simmer we played in Leipzig. If you remember that. The ending was similar.
You mean at the Euronics
Yeah,
stand,
exactly, Runix boot.
the Beta Pro thing?
Yeah, exactly. There was that one TDC map with a similar ending turn.
Yeah.
I don't know why it reminded me of that, but it did. It did anyway. How's work going for you?
Yeah, decent. I'm happy that it's now over for this year. Oh,
Yeah.
it's already Halloween again.
Yeah, time goes by quickly.
It's definitely stressful working. Also, the weekends are stressful because of Trackmania Cups. Like, each single weekend there is something. Like, I search for weekends that are freed in order to drive to Leipzig then. But it's impossible to find any. Really, each weekend you can fight for a lot of prize money. Problem is, of
Yeah.
course, getting training for this, for these cups, because I work and don't have that much free time, and I'm often pretty tired and not really full focused then. And yeah, that's of course the
Yeah, totally.
negative thing now.
Is there really that much prize money? Is it really worth it to drive every single one of them?
Yeah, it would probably make more sense to focus sometimes on one cup and then be really good there and win. But you never know beforehand which cup is sensible to go for. But yeah, I mean, there is prize money of like 100 euro for sure in basically all of these cups, you can say.
I mean, yeah, but in total, right? Not for the first place.
Yeah, depends, but minimum in total.
Yeah, okay. Well, I don't know. I mean, it's nice to have, but I would assume you earn enough that you shouldn't, like,
No,
don't
I don't
care
need
that
it, of
much about
course,
prize money.
but it makes these cups interesting.
Yeah, of course, it makes the cups interesting, but you don't have to play every single one of them, right? Especially if you
I
don't
just
care
can't
that much about
let them pass.
it. I mean, as long as you enjoy that, I don't mind it. I mean, I would have the
I
time
mean,
for it.
I always find an argument for each single cup of them that it's actually sensible to participate in it.
I mean, if you think so, then it is like that. I mean, Who's gonna tell you what's useful and what not, right? If you feel like the time is well spent, then it is. That's how it works.
Ja, weil when the weekend is over, it's always like, I now work again.
Ja, aber but that's your own fault. But I can assure you, going back to school after working is not really better.
Yeah, I think.
At least in my case.
I think earlier we took school just as it is, but if you think about it, it's also being long, long way, long time out of the
but
house.
That's actually not my biggest problem, to be honest. I couldn't care less about the time I've spent there. I just have different problems. You know, since I voluntarily said, yeah, I want to learn more, I want to do this, I'm motivated for this. I was actually, like, at least kind of motivated to learn, you know. Not that motivated, but I was motivated enough to at least go for it. And I enjoyed it the first couple of weeks, actually, but now it's just... I mean, I wouldn't say the others are dumb, but I'm definitely faster at learning than most of them, at least in the topics that I, like, interest for. Like, I don't care about German, I don't care about ethics. I mean, I do care about ethics, you know, but those are subjects you learn for. You don't have to understand them, you just have to learn them. And I only care about subjects like physics and maths and IT and all those things where you have, and you get presented a new problem or a new kind of thing and you have to understand it and then use it. And while I already understood it, We're still like learning it for another 3 hours or so. Like, that's so boring. I mean, I can't like blame anyone for that. I mean, but it's so fucking boring anyway. I just feel like I'm wasting my time there. I mean, I'm wasting my time at home as well, but at least at home I can choose what I do. Yeah, I don't know.
Could have watched so many more animes.
Yeah. Not like that, but I mean, I'm sitting there and I want to learn something and I can't learn something because the other ones are still learning something I already understood, right? So I'm just kind of frustrated with the fact that I can't learn more in the time I'm there because I would want to learn more. I don't know. I guess I just shouldn't care that much about it. It's just 1 year. When I begin studying yet next year, I guess it won't be that big of a problem anymore, because in universities nobody is caring about people not understanding it. They're just gonna continue the subjects. If someone didn't understand it, yeah, whatever. That's how. Nah, I'm not sure if I should say that's how it should be, but I'm still looking forward to it. Well, if I'm gonna study next year, that is. I'd actually postpone it for another year.
Top 5 within 700s.
Actually, might want to study exactly what Onyo is studying.
Okay.
Like completely the same. I mean, not that big of a surprise maybe, but kind of funny maybe. Though he's like in his last year already. So when I'm gonna start, he's already finished. So what do you think about the first map, second map?
It's okay.
I mean, it's pretty basic. Well, not basic, but nothing really fancy about it, maybe.
That could be my problem in the end.
Yeah, true, it's...
Oh, Joseph.
But it's only the second map, so... We'll see. Kinda thought that would be a difficult jump, because of the screenshot. But... That turned out to be not true at all. Hitting that checkpoint gonna be really...
Yeah, I was very close to it in the round before this. Ah, damn. A different line for that one corner.
Yo, some people are going up so much.
Decent run, if I hadn't fucked up that one corner, so it's now close to second again. Yeah. Yesterday I was in the cinema with Lars in Star Wars.
Oh yeah, yeah, you already wrote it. You actually liked it, right?
Yeah. Pretty good. As a finish of all the episodes.
Well, I mean, I didn't watch any Star Wars episode at all, so I couldn't care less.
Okay.
I mean, people in my class actually wanted to watch it together, but... I mean, what merit would I have in watching a movie I didn't watch the prequel, like the 8 prequels? I mean, maybe not. Maybe I don't need to watch all 8.
Yeah, and the spin-offs.
Of them, but still, right.
And the spin-offs. Watch...
Yeah, exactly. But even then, if you're gonna watch the sequel, the spin-offs, why don't you watch the original ones first as well? Well, you can't watch everything, so I don't mind it that much. Just not
I watched all 6 episodes after my now German-English wisdom teeth were removed.
What's German English about that? That's like.
Is that so. Actually correct? Can you?
Yeah, it's wisdom teeth. It really is. I don't even know why I would know that. I definitely know that for some reason. But yeah, I feel you. I had the same thing. And even though it wasn't really that difficult for me because it was like over in 2 minutes, you have a lot of time then, like being at home, nothing to do otherwise.
Mm.
How long did you stay at home? Like 2 or 3 weeks?
Well, I don't remember. It was when I was a child.
Oh, okay. Yeah, for me it was like 2.5 years ago. And for some reason I only had 3 instead of 4. Or 2 or whatever. Pretty, I don't know, random that I had like an odd number of wisdom teeth. Oh, pretty interesting map. It could actually suit you, at least more than the other one. A little bit weirder.
Mm. Ryulo got 5 finals in a row. But the last 5 TTCs were all not tech. It was always something different.
Oh really?
Yeah.
Well, I mean, I figured him winning Valley, but... Oh right, I actually played the Dirt TTC. And I wasn't even that bad, I think.
Oh yeah, I think I actually recognized
Yeah, I just failed the finish jump in a specific round somehow.
My problem is that I missed many TTCs and shit, and many shitfests due to work, because I often have late shifts and they are somehow all the time on Monday and Thursday, like the two worst possible days you could imagine for it. That was really annoying for me. I missed so many, and then the TTCs that I've been here, there were three where I got disconnect after in the first map change, where the map changed, I ended up on the next map, but just with please wait, and this didn't go away.
Yeah, I know that. I don't know how that happens, to be honest. It's a little bit weird. Not the typical disconnecting, it's just, I don't know, very, very weird.
Yeah, and in that moment when the warm-up is over, then it kicks me.
Yeah, I only had it once, like in Nations Forever actually, like years ago.
Back in Nations Forever?
Yeah, like half, like once half a year or like 4 times a year or so. I was waiting there and waiting and I didn't really notice it, and then I put like, I had the stream running next to it, and then in the stream they were starting to drive. Then I put cars on and I saw them finishing, and then I was like, hey, what the fuck is going on here? Something is wrong. Why am I not driving? And they are. So yeah, I don't know. I guess it's more or less, I mean, it must have to do with the internet, but it's not a disconnect, it's something else, something weird.
Yeah, it for sure has to do with the internet, but it's weird because you loaded the map, you loaded in, and after that, after I rejoined, no problem. Afterwards,
I guess maybe it just desynced somehow, and the game didn't know what to do with you anymore. I don't know.
It's just weird. And yeah.
It might be because of your LTE internet, because I remember back when I had it that one time, we still had that really old internet connection that was
it's definitely the internet is the reason for it. The thing is, the internet was alright in speed-wise, like it made the speed test beforehand and it was decent, like really good. So that can't be, it can't be the speed, it is something different of it.
Yeah, I mean with Trackmania, it usually never is about the speed, right?
Right now I always have to, if I use the Giga Cube, to be safe, I always have to restart the Giga Cube, restart the internet right before the TC, then it's no problem, but at least so far it was no problem.
As long as it works.
Yeah, it actually helps a lot. It's weird. I have often, when I want to stream, I found out a few times, where is my upload gun? Like, upload was then down to like 0 point something. Stream was impossible to do. And after I restarted, the upload went again up to 15 megabyte per second or 16, 17, now even at 21. But always after it restarts, it's at a normal speed. But if I just put on my computer and want to drive, then sometimes it's also there, but sometimes also it goes down to like 0 out of nowhere, or 1, or very low. And yeah, now I always restart the Giga Cube each single time.
Weird. Maybe it's broken somewhere, but who knows. German internet connection, right? So
yeah.
Probably nothing you can do about that. Unless getting maybe a fixed one, but you can't, so. Ah, whatever, it's just, I guess it's more or less just Germany.
Yeah.
I got a friend that like moved for the second time now, and at home he had really shitty internet, like really slow one, like too slow to do anything at all, even if his parents didn't do anything as well. Then he moved out, had a pretty good connection from speed wise, but it was really unstable. And now he moved out like somewhere else and he again got a connection that's pretty fast but also pretty unstable. So no matter what he does, he can't really play any games. At least not real-time based games like Rocket League or whatever.
Mm.
So weird.
Apropos Rocket League, I just played it like an hour ago. Three games in 1v1 and at my level there. I actually won them all, so I'm happy.
Yeah, nice. Now you can put it away for another 5 months and...
Yeah, it wasn't that long ago that I played it before, and still some weeks, but there was also a month where I played it pretty often with Lars and first month sometimes.
Not Firestorm?
Yeah, also Firestorm sometimes. So.
Yeah, I don't know, I didn't play Rocket League for probably half a year maybe even. Yeah, I don't know. I'm just
there's a hairpin. There's a hairpin. Ui. We get something different here.
I mean, as you can see, I'm in PAG Team 2 now again, so I'm not really that active. Although, I wasn't more active in Team 1, so.
How active is Dexter?
Oh, Dexter is actually pretty active. Like, I mean, now it's over, but they were pretty pretty motivated. So I guess now he's not active at all, because the tournament season is over for now, but during the season, he and the other guys were pretty active in Team 1. As far as I can tell. I mean, and I can't tell really well, so I don't know. All I know is they were motivated, and... Like, the way it usually is, if they are motivated, they also train a lot, so I just assume they also trained a lot, because otherwise I think they would have talked about that, maybe.
Yeah, I mean, they got good positions, I guess.
Yeah, exactly. I
saw THE pretty often in the podium.
And even in the final, where they lost, they were like, yeah, we had a pretty bad day today, instead of saying, yeah, maybe we should have trained more. So, I guess they were prepared pretty well, that's what I think.
Voyager is there.
I kind of feel like THG is way better doing every single time I'm not in the team. Like, really though. I mean, of course, I'm not really like the one causing it all the time, but...
You also see that in some football teams sometimes. You have that star player, everything goes with a star player. Yeah, I mean, earlier when I was going into THE as well with you, and I was also playing with them, you were the star player.
Yeah, but that's so many years ago already.
I mean, all these LANs that you had with THE were always the winner.
Yeah, well... Yeah, but still, right? Nowadays it's different. When I'm playing a map in THE, no matter if it's team... Well, Team 2 it might be different, but in Team 1, every time I was playing a map...
Or Link Lucky.
That meant that not enough people were trained or motivated for that map. More or less, because I only played if I needed to. I mean, I didn't play bad, but still.
I always want to jump against the pole.
Yeah, kinda, right? Standing there, arms open.
Yeah, as if the turn goes more to the right. I always forget that. I really can't focus today, I don't know.
You should drink a couple of beers. Won't make you focus any better, but might still help in some way or another. This turn is actually pretty weird.
Because it's not a standard corner.
Just difficult to get right. I'm always overshooting the exit.
So what do you say actually about all this Team GL stuff? Like the way it goes, the game?
Not really motivating me. But, I mean, I'm not that into it, but what I dislike the most is already the point system. And that's like where I already want to stop, right? I mean, I saw the maps, and I think I saw all of them now, and I can live with those identities more or less, right? It's still TMGL, but it's fine, right? I mean, it's somewhat predictable. It's predictable enough that I don't care about it. That I say, okay, now I can live with that, right? You can make it work. That's what's important, right? You can make it work consistently or somewhat consistently, and that's what's important. I don't want any like lol stuff or like random stuff that's so difficult that you can't consistently make it even if you train. And that's definitely not something like that, in my opinion at least. But the format of losing points is just not making any sense. Like, where is the fairness? I mean, of course it's still fair because it's the same rules for everyone, but I don't know the word for it. I mean, it's definitely not, like, you can't say it's unfair, but it's just, I don't like it. It's made in a way where I don't, like, it's making the last couple of maps way more important than the first ones. And although I don't dislike that approach, I dislike the way they made it. Because they made it so that the first couple of maps don't matter at all. You know, saying the last couple of maps are more important in some way or another, okay. But the way they implemented it, you can just say, yeah, I don't care about the first couple of maps, I'm just gonna train the last one. And you're gonna still maybe do better than some unlucky dude having a bad run on the last map.
But you will do worse than someone who scores good points on the first maps and keeps his points.
Yeah, if he keeps his points, that's for sure. That's why it's a fair system, right? But I still don't like it. It's so much against my inner, I don't know, I hate it from the very the whole essence of my body just wants to dislike the system. You know, I can't say it's a bad system. Of course it's, but
yeah,
I can't really argue against it. All I can say is I dislike it because of this and that. And then Nadir's gonna argue, yeah, but it's gonna make it more interesting in the stream. And of course that's true, but I still hate it. Right? And it's so demotivating that I don't even care about like training. I mean, I might still think about it, but it's just, I don't know. It just speaks so much against myself. I just don't like it at all.
But actually my question was more meant the thing with the champions that don't need to qualify and just are there in the Grand League now.
Yeah, but how did they select them though?
Like in all the orc organization stuff, like the orcs. Yep. I guess that Softy was trying to get the orcs and they choose players. Probably got hints or I don't know.
Yeah, but they chose the players more or less, like, they chose the players based on how they did in the TMPL in the bitter season, right? Or did they just say, yeah, we want this and that player in it and the rest has to qualify?
Yeah, that's the annoying thing. I would say the last one, because there are players in that were not playing TMPL. Like Matt.
I mean, it pretty much feels like they just strapped people that are, like, they just want to make a show out of it. Like, it's the same feeling you had during the beta. They don't care about, like, having a competition or something. I mean, they do care about having a competition, but they want to, like, emphasize people, like, cheering on their beloved or most liked players and, like, the way they handle the streams and everything. It just shows that they don't want you to enjoy it as a whole tournament. They just want you to, like, spectate one of the players and cheer them on. That's how they want it to work. And of course people always will have a favorite player or something like that sometimes, but that's not the way I would want to watch those kind of shows, you know? Like when I watch a football match, or like a match in any kind of game or esports or whatever the fuck it is, right? I watch it from the neutral perspective, from the caster perspective, and never from the player's perspective. I mean, even when I watch some dude streaming some game, like let it be Rocket League, for example. If I watch someone play Rocket League, I got like two or three people I watched, and then they play in a tournament and they stream it. I would still prefer to watch the casting instead of watching their stream. Oops. Well, that was a bad start by me. Holy shit. Just so straight into the wall. I'm actually last, I think. No, I'm second last. I don't know how someone can be behind me, but... yeah. Yeah, but I don't know. I mean, I see where they are trying to go, and I guess it can work. But I just dislike that this is like the biggest tournament we have, right? If this would be something alongside other events, I wouldn't care that much. I would say, yeah, okay, it's a cool concept, maybe. Let's see how it goes. Let's see what people think about it. Why not? But this, as the main and biggest esports tournament in Trackmania, is just giving me a bad feeling. I don't know. I don't like it.
I could assume, actually, that you are the reason why Softy is picking every single player. Because I guess he hated when Pac didn't qualify for Team PL. because there was just this one show match, and then it was just not Pac, it was also Spam who didn't qualify.
Yeah, but I did well in this season as well, and I mean, of course, Pac would have had like more viewers or more people cheering him on, but I think I still had like a couple of people.
No, that's of course clear. But I guess that Softy really wants a league where all the biggest names that you have in this game play against each other. What I of course dislike is, for one thing, is are they also that motivated? That these matches will be close. I mean, last TMGL season, there were not that many close matches. It was sometimes easy for some people to consistently get top 8 because some people didn't appear at some point. Others were always far behind. And yeah, now they wanted to make a better competition. Yeah, but are these players now really also that motivated? That's the first question. Next thing is, it's of course perfect for the players that are now in the Grand League, and it's probably also good for viewers that these players are thriving against each other. But for other drivers that would like to be in the Grand League, this is so horrible. I mean, these maps, these kind of maps, and this format with laps mode, it would suit me as well. I would love to be part of that, or at least have a chance to qualify. I mean, you can't really say that I had a chance last time when we had basically tech maps in the qualification, and then only two spots in whole Germany plus Austria and so on. This was basically no chance. It were different maps as well as we had in the competition itself.
Yeah.
And now people like me, but also many others, are just not in. Yeah, and have no chance. Like, there is not a single possibility to get into this first league. And in order to get into the second league, you have to be the best of everyone else.
That's pretty ridiculous.
I mean, maybe you can also be second and third best and be lucky to get in, but yeah. For me, it's now too late, because when I start working, when I have my license, I mean. When I get my license, then I will switch my working place, and then I will have a different shift system. Then I'm at a 13 hours shift. Like, it's a 24 hours working place, basically, with two shifts. And these works could be at any day. They could be also on Saturday, also on Sunday. It could be day or it could be night. It's everything possible, so I can't plan anything. Like when I have now a competition with a season, it's impossible for me then, because I will definitely, out of 7 Sundays or so, I will definitely miss out on 2 or 3. Like, I would say on 2 Sundays. Depends a bit how many other colleagues are in holidays or something.
I mean, the idea of such a big tournament usually is that the people that are playing in it are just like living off of it, usually. Or at least it's like that big of that, such a big part of their life that they can just tell the work, yeah, I need that and that time off because I'm more or less like.
Yeah, but this is of course something. So far, I could do it always, and at the moment, I'm using every weekend for it to be able to play competitions, but. When I have the license, this will just brutally change. The thing is, I have of course also many, many free days in the week. Like I have then sometimes only 3 days in the week that I work, and 4 free days. But these 3 days, they are partly also in the week. That has advantages because I can like go to the haircut or. To stuff, and other people are working, so I'm pretty alone doing that, and that's of course all right. But the negative thing is I can't plan anything, and all the seasonal stuff, which is always on the same day of the week over many weeks, like also the XD race, which is Fridays, it won't work anymore. All these things can't work anymore.
Yeah, but no matter which game and which tournament you would participate in, this would be the same problem everywhere. Even with normal sport, like, I mean, so normal, but like even like sports club or sport tournaments or anything, it would be the same problem there as well, right? You can't really blame anyone for that. It's just the way it is.
Yeah.
Like, that's not really, I mean, that's, yeah, that's bad luck for you, but I mean, that's to be expected.
Yeah, but what I wanted to say is that this was now basically maybe my last chance to participate in something like this. And even if I drive not the Open League and really, really well, somehow, even if I do that, I will have the biggest problem that even if I qualify for the next season, I can't really play that on each single step. And so this now would have been my last chance, and I'm not able to qualify for it.
Yeah, I don't know what they are going for, to be honest. I don't know. I mean, they are definitely just going for the biggest show, to be honest. I mean, you can see by the... I mean, if you have those kind of identities on the map, even if you can like do them consistently with training, if you have that kind of mode with laps and endurance thing, then you're never gonna have close races, except like a couple of times and like between a couple of players, but you're never gonna have a big pack of players at the same position in the map. That's just not how endurance works. That's just to be expected, especially with those kind of maps, right? So that can't be what they are going for. So they are just going for like exactly what you think, right? Just the biggest show. Because you can't just say, yeah, they want the best players, because of course, like you said that I kicked down Peck, and yeah, true, but in the second season already, Peck was in it, and Spam as well, so like at that point we already had the best players, at least all of the players that wanted to be in it, because everyone had the chance, and everyone that didn't make it the first time, 100% did it the second time, because like winning the second league was not that difficult for the best players at least, right? So you already had all the best players in TMPL. At least the ones you wanted to have. Of course, the best players is like a list of players that differs from TMPL to TMGL, but that's mostly because of the style of the event already, so... I mean, some people that are doing really, really well in TMGL, or will do really, really well in TMGL now, are some players that would not do that well in TMPL, simply because of the style of the maps. And, I mean, that's natural, right? So, in the end,
Yeah, but then
they
he
chose the other maps for a reason.
Yeah, but then now people like Tween, for example, get just a champion just because of his name, because of Tween. But I mean, he has to prove first that he's like decent on these maps. For example, Tween is just an example.
Yeah, I know what you mean. I also find it unfair, but that's how they decided to do it. They didn't want to bother with some open qualifications, I guess, and that's the easiest way they figured it out to do it otherwise.
Yeah, and then the other thing is, when I heard first time that Riulu will be probably driving the next season, without doing anything, of course, for it, yeah, just getting into, but when I figured out that, I thought, well, then he's not casting anymore, maybe I could apply as caster then, it would be a great chance, but no. Now we have 16 different casters who just focus on their mates, and
yeah,
this is...
I don't know, it's a system you either like or dislike. I personally definitely dislike it. I don't know that many people that like it either, but... yeah, whatever, right? I mean, like, for honesty, I'm just done arguing about this topic. I'm just done arguing about the Dio shit at all. Like, no matter when and what kind of topic I talk about it, it just gets me mad. And makes me want to stop playing Trackmania. And that's probably still a reason why I don't play Trackmania more often. Because I like the game, but every single time I invest more time in the game, this person should naturally come up, because it's just part of the game. But when you talk about features of the game and development of the game and things that happened in the past 3 years and TMGL, I just get so mad at most of these things, or maybe even all of those things. I don't know, it just makes me want to stop playing again, because I just don't want to talk about those things. It's just, it's pointless, right? You already know that, it's pointless. No matter what we do, even if like 90% of the community would say, yeah, let's do it this way and not that way, even then, Nadir wouldn't change it, because Hylus still is always believing that he is doing the right thing and what he does must be right, and even if he fails with something, he doesn't care about it. He's not saying, yeah, maybe you guys were right. No, he's just saying, yeah, no negative feeds, right? I mean, of course it's part of the meme, and of course some people definitely, like, were too negative, but when you're CEO of a game, maybe not when you're CEO, I guess it's already the main problem already is that Hylus is the CEO. He is not the community manager. He should stop trying to be community manager when he's the CEO. Those are just two positions in a company that should not be that close together, right? I don't know.
Who is the real community manager?
Well, Ali Noah kind of is, but... I mean, they... Serovan was it, but I think he left or something like that, and since then Ali Noah is the only one doing it. Yeah, I don't know. I mean, I just don't want to discuss about that all that much. I just dislike the topic overall. There are so many things that people like no. I mean, you can't say everything is bad, but even then, there's nothing really that good you can talk about for a longer part of, like, for a long time, right? I mean, every single good thing they added is just like a neat feature, right? It's just a small thing, and every single thing that's a little bit bigger is something at least I personally dislike. I mean, I guess there need to be others that like it, but at least from my point of view, I dislike most of what they are doing.
Oh wow, we have all... oh no. I thought we have only 2 KOs, but it's weird, there is minus 2, but below there stands 3.
Yeah, it's weird indeed.
I think it was like that also the past TTCs.
Well, just a small bug, I guess. I think because the minus... I don't know. I really don't know. It's a little bit weird. Can we play Volvic? But yeah, I mean, in some way or another, I should maybe even be happy about TMGL, right? Except from the identities, usually it should be something that suits me, right? Maybe the laps are a little bit short, but the maps from this season are way better than before. And even the ones before, I wouldn't have done that badly, maybe.
Well, I think two maps have weird identities. I am basically played this test step, no trained. And I was, of course, afraid of this one big flip upwards and downwards into the quarter pipe, and this.
Yeah,
and I never. And in this identity on a map that I really didn't drive a single time before this qualification phase, with the many, many downhill platforms that you jump diagonally.
Yeah. Although that one didn't even look that bad.
I mean, like the new slide thing, identity is of course super good for me and makes of course no problem at all. Like everyone can drive that.
Even if you're not good at new sliding, right? It's not. Not that big of
a It won't time, ruin your run, basically. But the other two things, they can ruin your run.
Exactly. And if they ruin your run, then completely. Just like that one guy that drove up the checkpoint. His run is also ruined in this run. I mean, if you just... I mean, if I weren't into the Game Trick Mania, and if I would just watch TMGL, and if I would see players driving on those maps with the identities, I would probably enjoy it, right? I mean, it's kind of exciting watching them, like, trying to survive it, but I'm not, right? So that's how I view it. But even then, I don't like the fact they handle the streaming.
Yeah, I'm also wondering who should I actually spectate them. Like, this is really a bad part. But people are, of course, discussing already. And I actually sent pre-yesterday a PM to Softy where I just told them if things will be changed and there is an official caster being used, I would be interested. Just that you know. I wrote him. Of course, no answer from him or anything.
Yes, he's never gonna answer you, trust me on that one. I think...
Like, I know it's probably a lost hope. But I thought, before I do nothing and in the end I announce a cast and he searches his own guys, I just write him, because Asteri told me he's building a TMGL map, and I told him, huh, I thought Softy is choosing who is building TMGL maps, and then Asteri said, no, I asked him. And then I thought, huh, like, you can ask him, and then he says, yes, okay. And Asteri, I mean, huh?
When I asked Softy anything, like, even, yo, how was your day, he won't answer. like half a year ago or something like that, he questioned me, yo, Shorty, are you there? I need you for something. And, no shit, right? Like, 5 or 10 minutes later, I answered, yo, I'm here, what do you need for me for? And he never replied. And before that,
exactly.
There were like three or four messages by me asking him something, and he didn't reply to them as well. I don't know what to think about that, to be honest. But well, I don't have anything to do with him anymore, I guess, kind of.
I have always the feeling that he doesn't like us, even though I wouldn't know why he shouldn't like you, but...
I don't know either. I mean, I was the co-leader of his fucking team. Like, I did it when he wasn't there, but I think I did a good job. Maybe not as a player, but as a person at
least. As a player as well, I would say. I mean,
I could have done worse, right? I mean, the other players weren't really outperforming me as well, and so yeah.
And then we just both got kicked, kinda. I mean, I was also in that team, and yeah, of course, it was a only tech tournament that we played. Of course, I couldn't perform there very well, obviously. Like,
I mean, I understood why he did what he did, right? I mean, he tried to find an organization that would keep all of us, and it failed. And then he decided, okay, I'm gonna try it only with French people, and obviously it worked. So, can't really blame him, right? It obviously, it was the right decision, or at least not a bad one. But for us, it was like him, yeah, okay. And afterwards, then he just didn't keep responding to my messages, and I don't know if that's... if I'm okay with that. I mean, I guess I'm not, right? I mean... Even if he didn't like me, then for once, why should he make me the co-admin and host, like, manage things that, like, why? I just don't understand it. Like, it's not like I asked him, like, questions where he needed to invest, like, 50 minutes of his precious time just to give me a clear answer or something like that. It was, like, easy stuff, right? He could have also just answered, yeah, sorry, man, don't have the time for that or something like that, right? Just didn't respond at all. And when he wants something of you, he's just like, yeah, do it today or right now or something like that. Well, now he's not. Now he didn't contact me for a long while, so whatever. It's just a little bit weird. I mean, I don't want to complain that much, but it's just weird, right? I just don't really understand it that well. Not like I hate him now, but it's just weird. Just doesn't make any sense to me.
Hello Maxi and yeah, Patty, TTC Deep Talk, yeah.
Yeah, well, I didn't start it, okay.
But you are good at continuing.
Yeah, the beer might help me. I mean, it's TTC, right? Like, if I wouldn't talk, what else would I do, right? There's nothing to do, I think. Under top 20 or so. Well, maybe top 30, but still.
Well, I have to watch out a bit earlier. There were plenty of rounds where I only got 15th or something. Yeah, because of my really bad focus today. And yeah,
but even then, you only get that bad of a position if you, like, make a mistake. And even if you get out, you just get out. Even then, it just doesn't make sense to concentrate on the game.
But what is really funny again is that this is now the, like, sixth round in a row that I'm really a second behind the leader. Like, always between 0.95 and 1.0.
You're already keeping your safe distance, huh?
Who is in the voice chat? Oh, you don't know it?
Yeah, well...
Make a guess.
I mean, I sound a little bit deeper than usually because I'm a little bit sick.
Yeah, I actually also found it out that you sounded a bit different.
Yeah, you just found it out after like 1 hour.
Ah, a bit earlier.
Yeah. I can't really tell how much different it really sounds. I just, like, you hear your own voice a little bit different, so tough to say. But now, since I actually feel better, I don't really mind about my voice being a little bit deeper.
Haha, come, and 0.998. And it was already obvious in the last checkpoint that it will end like that.
But if you guys still need a hint, you could say I'm the one with the best skin ever.
Mm. 0.998. But can I get one better run, maybe? I mean, I want to get a bit closer at some point. But I really don't feel it today, I don't know.
I mean, that doesn't really have to be a bad sign in TDCs.
Yeah, I mean, let's say in MX knockouts, I sometimes won exactly those knockouts that I was pretty bad and didn't really have the feeling, and yeah, and there were other knockouts where I actually got warmed up beforehand, with other cups or something like that, and I thought, okay, now I'm warmed up, now I'm feeling great, and then it didn't end up that nicely. 0.89 this time at least. But in TTCs it's of course different. Like I can't win if I don't feel perfect on tech maps, I mean.
Oh, now I get it. You know what? The 2 is the right number, but the 3 below is what it actually should be. Because I was actually wondering, why is this taking so long? Why are we still that? Like, it should progress faster. Maybe. It's kicking the wrong number of people. It should still kick 3, like, it should even kick 4 players. And it's only kicking 2 players each round. Oh wow, what am I doing?
Is that full speed, this right downhill?
Yeah. If you get the turn 4 right, I think so.
This time I'm a bit further behind because of an early mistake.
Yeah, I'm 1.7 seconds behind as well.
Yeah, how you can be happy.
Oh, I guess they found a way to fix it.
So now you get third last.
Really, I have no idea how to drive this.
Like, I'm already 8/10 behind.
I'm not sure if I'm fine or not. Like, in terms of speed for the later rounds. Oh, I guess I am. Oh, I'm not. Oh. Even when I try, I don't get into top 5. Ah.
Oh, he's still in. Again with plus 5.
I mean, this will be a pretty long TTC.
It's a break.
Oh. Should I open another bottle of beer? Or not?
No.
Why no? I could talk even more bullshit. Yeah, but what I'm definitely gonna do is I'm gonna go to the toilet real quick, so be right back.
Okay. So Maxi, did you find out who it is? for the first time. Please what? You definitely survived another time as well. Until the break.
Hello.
Hello.
But I wasn't sure about it, but I made up my mind and... Oh, you can't hear it. Okay, whatever.
I wonder what to say you.
Huh?
Okay. I wonder what Devil would actually say about all this Team GL stuff. Because he has, I think, still no idea what's going on.
He would probably not say a lot about it. Or would he? He's sometimes joining my team speak, and almost always disconnecting.
I mean, I can see him maybe liking that there's no more. It's more going into esports and with orcs and stuff and prize money, but he probably dislikes it's not tech anymore, not full tech. Okay, clear water, good luck. You know what's funny? At work, we have many colleagues that are actually also playing games on computer or PlayStation or something. Like many.
It's not that uncommon.
Yeah, but it's so funny. And even my 60 years old Ausbilder bought now a PlayStation and many games.
Nice. I like that. Isn't that nice though? I mean,
yeah, it's pretty funny and cool. But also all the others, like one of them streamed 2 days ago. I saw it on YouTube actually.
Becoming more and more frequent. That's how it is. I love how the number of chaos is just random more or less at the moment. that's like a pretty nice format idea, right? Just don't know how many knockouts there be. There's gonna be a random number of knockouts between 1 and 10, and just don't know how many it will be.
Would still be pretty good for me, in most cases.
Yeah, would still be the same for us, mostly. Yeah.
But when we are down to top 20 or something,
yeah,
could knock me out then if there's a minus 10.
Yeah. Oh god. Don't think I'm gonna survive this very long.
On this track I was incredibly slow. I have to... And also on the next one I didn't.
I mean, I think it's natural that you're slow on this one, but I still think this might be the best map for you because people are gonna crash here more often, maybe.
You never get a good exit out of the very last
turn. Yeah.
I'm always too far inside, basically. It's
I'm always starting the drift too early. By the way, since we still got a lot of time, I can ask you a pretty difficult question. I'm gonna have to tap a little backstory first, but it's not gonna take too long.
Oh, yeah.
More or less about what I should do for next year in the end. Not sure if you already know that or not, but what I initially wanted to do after this year was like studying. So I mean, what I'm doing right now is like 1 year of school, so I'm allowed to study, right? Like yeah, whatever it was called in English. I actually had that in a lesson, but yeah, whatever.
Abitur. You do now Abitur? In order to study?
So I'm more or less like, yeah, whatever. Like, I can study afterwards.
Lol, Patty. Oh, where did you that one come? Where did you that get that from?
What did he do?
He posted my save emote with a Christmas hat.
Ah, yeah, nice. Yeah, so anyway, since I had time to and thought about it, and I wasn't really like, yeah, I need to study right now, I really want to this or that. I was like, yeah, I don't really know, but I want to learn Japanese. So I was like, yeah, why just don't I go to Japan for 9 months and learn the language in the school there? But then the problem is that costs a shit ton of money. So if I want to do that, I basically have to spend all my money, even my savings. But on the other hand, like, I need to spend my savings for my study anyway, right? So I kind of think it's not that big of a deal.
I thought you want to study something which is close to your, well, job, what you want to do later.
Yeah, the field, yeah, but not like geographically, I don't care at all. I already know that I want to be an exchange student in Japan, if I can. But I want to be able to speak fucking Japanese, and if you want to learn a language, then you should learn it in the country where it's born. So, I mean, there are like work and travel things you can do, but that's not really a way to learn a language, right? Especially a language that's really difficult for us to learn. So I want to learn properly, but then you have to pay money for it. But why would I save money when working, right? Why did I save the money if I don't use it on this kind of stuff? It's not that much money anyway. Put it in perspective at least, right? If you say, yeah, I did it for a house or something like that, which is ridiculous. I kind of like just spend it for the study itself anyway, so I can just spend it for that. Since during the study, if I need more money, I can always start part-time working something. But once I start my study, I can't really say, yeah, I'm gonna take a year off and learn Japanese in Japan. I can still make it part of my study, but I don't know, a little bit difficult. There's no right or wrong in there, it's a problem. More about what I think is like making me enjoy it the most. Since if I would study where Onyo studied, then I would like learn Japanese at the university. Which is also fine, but I'm not sure if that's enough for me, to be honest. I mean, once I have it in the university and then I like go for exchange here in Japan, it would be pretty good as well, but I can just learn the language in Japan for a year, then stop my study and make an exchange year then in Japan, right? And that would be way better. I mean, not really better, but at least I would be better in the language, and being able to speak a language does help.
I was able to speak some Japanese, and now it's so long ago. I only know the numbers. Since years, I only know the numbers and Watashiwa.
You kind of had to learn it, right? Didn't like say, yeah, I really want to learn it, right?
Yeah, exactly. But I said I want to have this this lesson in the exams of the 10th grade.
Yeah, I mean, you still chose it at least somehow. Yeah, I don't know. I just like language. Like, even if you asked me why I would like to want to learn the language, I wouldn't be able to say, yeah, I want to learn the language because of this or that. It's not like, yeah, I want to live or work in Japan, even though it's definitely a thing I would consider, right? I wouldn't mind doing that. I would maybe even want to do that, but it's not like I want to learn the language because I want to do that. It's like, I'm not fixed on anything. I just want to learn the language because I like the language. I also don't want to learn the language because I want to read manga or something like that. I mean, of course, that would be great, and I would do that then, of course, but I'm fine with translated stuff. It's just, I don't know why. I just like the language, in a way. Everything else is just, like, nice to have as well. I was pretty close, actually.
On this map, I was super slow.
I had a really bad crash. Could have been horrible.
Clearwater still in. Deska, Rokette, Astronaut, Spluk, so many known names there. Hallo, Seppel.
I wanted to ride more, but I couldn't. Oh, this start is so...
Like Clearwater win this.
Yeah, that would be nice, actually. I'm in for that. I support it.
I have so many troubles with this car. Yeah, and this one. This is like the worst possibility.
Yeah.
It's like, again, such an auto-slide corner, you need to get the auto-slide. And if you don't get the auto-slide because you have less speed from the turn before, you definitely get the no-slide, and there is just no fast way if you have that wrong speed to it.
Yeah.
You can't do anything. I really dislike that, it's so unsafeable then.
Well, of course it's unsafeable if you don't like it. If it would be safeable, you would still like it. I bet. Oh, rip focus. Are you going inside at the very first pole already?
I did my first try, but not anymore.
Wait, really? But you're losing time with that, aren't you?
Probably losing time everywhere, so...
Yeah, good point, but still, I just wanted to know if it's like slower or not.
I don't know. I have interface off. And I need to focus again because I had touched.
Oh.
Yeah, I'm really struggling.
Yeah, I'm actually also pretty bad on this map.
I don't get any flow. Okay.
I'm 1 second behind, that's usually your distance.
Yeah, yeah, my distance here is 2.5 usually.
Yeah, see. Man. Maybe Mobby is helping. You know what, I'm just gonna go outside next round and try it. I'm so bad at inside pole, I might not even be faster when I do it like that. Although I'm not that far behind this time. This end is also so weird.
In this end here, you go left of the pole?
No, I go right.
I jump to the right of it. Okay.
Yeah. I do it. I don't think everyone is doing it. Oh, I don't know. But I guess the right side of the pole is better. So how... Huh. Apparently, going in between the first double poles is not really that better. Or easier. Pretty weird angle as well. But it still might be faster, because you get more speed out of it. Now the majority of people is going right side of the pole, but there are some people going to the left side of it.
I just tried right side for the first time, it was Monk Eyes.
Yes. Not that difficult though, if you used it.
I didn't actually realize, but seems like Clearwater's out. I see Patty's comment.
Oh, really?
Nice death jinx there, Marius, he wrote.
No, really? Didn't see it as well. No. I don't think so, though. I really didn't see it. Basso, Gessi, Vivek. Why can't you scroll up in chat? I mean. Huh. Oh, no warm up. Holy shit. That is unexpected. Slowly starting to drive like you. You're sliding almost every turn because of fear getting low slide. Ah.
TTC will end on my best map, I think.
Well, that's... I don't know. Good? Or not? Is it?
Yeah, it depends if I'm still in.
Yeah.
Probably not. Probably I will go out on my bad maps before. Or I go out on my good map now when we play it in this map rotation. It should be the next map. Like the one that we played first is my, I guess my best map.
I usually don't think about best or worst maps in TTCs because even when you're, at least in my case, even when I'm a little slower on one map, it's not because I'm driving something really wrong, it's just because I'm saving it more or less. And even if I'm really slower on a map, in the last couple of rounds it doesn't really. It's different anyways. So even if you're slower, you still might survive this map, and even if you're good on the other map, the others might be faster in one round as well.
First time I see Ryulu that he's participating. I never realized him in the top 5 yet, but I didn't look.
Well, to be honest, I didn't see him just now, and even though I looked, so...
Yeah, because he has now this long name.
Yeah, exactly.
Have to get used to it.
Gonna take it a bit. Ah, I lost my gear because I had to reduce. Oh.
I'm right behind you.
Yeah.
You're closer to a second then.
Start is so bumpy. That I'm not sure if I take it the right way or not. Oh! Okay. Let's stop risking. really hard to like find the perfect situation to start risking. You start risking too soon, you end up making a mistake, and if you just do it too late, you just go out on a good round.
Okay. Man, finally, I did a normal round, and I'm only 3/10 behind first.
You're in front of... Yeah, you're 11th. And 13th.
Yeah, 11th with only 3/10 behind, that's also crazy. Like, when I see how easy it is to get 20th with a second or something.
Uh-oh.
But this time I kept the speed from one turn, and then the next turn was also easier and so on.
I think I lose most of my time at the start already. Yeah, I do. Ah. My PC is overheating.
Now I have a really bad round again. Now I'm almost... you can almost see me there now.
This time I was 11. But with 0.6 behind, so... Oh yeah, now I see Riolo.
Yeah, but also Berkey.
Oh yeah, true.
And I have to remember how Riolo destroyed our chances for this ESC thing, and we would have an organization, we would have an org, we would be probably playing then in the Team Grand League.
We might even host tournaments, but anyway. Even then, we still can't like completely complain about Riolo there.
Can't we? Like, he just came late. All this thing was not possible just because of him, you can say.
Yeah, but I mean, I would have to look at the chat logs. I think it was kind of forced. Like, he already said that he might not be able to make it, right? So.
I have the difference in mind.
I don't know.
Maybe expected him to come there, definitely.
Yeah, maybe. Maybe he just expected it so much. I don't know. Who knows how it would look like. Maybe they would have kicked us after a couple of weeks already. Who knows?
Nobody knows. But it was our best chance. It was a German team. They had interest and everything. It really felt nice.
Well,
this chance
the only
and
time we ever tried, though. What are you?
Well, you tried a lot to reach others, and they were the only that.
Well, they weren't the only one, but.
yeah, it's also funny how we then didn't get the other team, obviously.
Well, obviously, we couldn't get the other team, but. I don't know. I'm still unsure about the other team, even though I kind of regret it as well, because they seemed really nice, and even if nothing would have happened there. Yeah, I don't know, whatever. It's Trackmania, man. Like, what good would have been, could have happened to us because of the droids? How much would an organization in Trackmania actually change for us? Not like
a long time, not really much.
Money or something, yeah, droids. Doesn't make that big of a difference in Trackmania.
Yeah, come on. Long time, it wouldn't have changed a lot, but now I know that you need an organization. Like, when you want to get into the Team Grand League and you need an org, I could of course think about asking Euronix, for example. Because why not?
Well, if it's really just about having an organization, it's definitely doable, right? Question is if they have to pay something or anything like that. Or do anything in particular, like social media or stuff. Because if I remember correctly, the problem with ESG was also that they never did anything on social media. But I guess that could have been changed if you wanted to. If it really is about organization, I think it's still possible to get in contact with Euronics Gaming again. I mean, we never had problems with each other, and we tried something, and therefore we left them, and they were okay with it, and it didn't work out for us, so we just stayed like that, because it wasn't really worth going back to ESG anyway, even if they would have let us, would have been...
Yeah, we never got any really support there.
Yeah, definitely.
Only Master got a devil for some time, that showed that there is potential at least, but
but like... Would things be different now? I mean, maybe Trackmania is doing a little bit better with all the French Cups that you are playing, but overall, not that significant, is it? I mean, I don't know the numbers. I guess if you like look at the live streams and all of that from you and from the tournaments, maybe it's not that bad. I don't know. I have no idea at all. But still, what would you want to ask for? Because I guess TMGL spots are already out now.
Yeah, of course, for the season now.
Yeah.
Right behind you.
It's gonna get... It's close now, and I'm not really fast on this map. Well, I never really tried to be fast on this map, so obviously I'm not fast, but... Now it's a little bit late. No, it's already in the last round. I'm just here for fun. Oh, Birgi is in first. Yo, Birgi, go, go.
Wow. This is nothing too special, actually. In the previous tech TTCs, he was always coming very, very far.
Yeah,
multiple finals.
I mean, I also didn't play Trackmania for quite a while, except some matches where I was barely trained.
Like, if you take Norderwind as if they would have existed earlier already, then I think. It's not just that 5 final streak by Ryulu, then it would continue with a Birgi streak as well.
I'm really sure about that. I wonder what Birgi is getting, and even if he, I mean, he might, of course, he's probably getting something, right? But even if he plays Trackmania or not, I don't think it makes a difference for him, does it? He's a manager, he doesn't need to play himself.
No, but just saying that he participates in this TTCs, and the previous tech TTCs, he was always getting into the finals consistently.
Yeah, I mean, it definitely like motivated him to play the game now again. At least participate more regularly in TTCs and stuff. Oh shit, that was bad.
But that was so safe.
That's like something only you would ever say. Like, maybe someone like Lars or Firestorm, but I would never imagine any tech player ever saying, "Oh, that was so safe." Like, never. They might ever say, "Oh, that was close," or "That was bad," or something like that, but they would never say, "Oh, that was way too safe." Like, never.
Like, you know, whenever you have these chicanes where you drift through, I have the fear to touch a border there, inside or outside, because both are being really big stoppings then, and definitely being knocking you out then. And in that corner now, I left so much room on the left side. I took no speed out of it up the hill here.
Yeah, the thing is, you're in front of me, Marius. not anymore. I risk that.
Yeah, and I still don't know how to take it there, to be honest. I thought that was safe. I lost 5 gears here.
Yeah, if it's only 5, someone else lost 6 probably.
Oh, yeah, actually, Doc is not far behind. But I lost all of that in the end. But wow, it's also so close. The third will be here. Spam and Ryulu. Ryulu even. Yeah, 14th. But the gap to get knocked out is so small.
Are there 3 knockouts? No.
Not 2, of course. From now on, just 1, I guess.
Yeah, just because the window was a little bit... Like, it looked like there was someone missing. Oh, okay, that's fine. Slowly starting to feel the beer. Oh, I got a gear down. I don't even know why, like, I'm saying, oh yeah, that was good, that was bad. But I'm in no danger at all.
Yeah, but I am out.
Wait, out?
Yes.
Just one knockout.
Yeah, oh, but I'm out.
No. No. Oh my god! No, Marius, why this round? Why does this always happen?
Yeah, this is incredible.
And why is it 2 knockouts?
It's still up to top 15 then. Man, Ryulu is so incredibly lucky there.
Why are why
I crash one time, yeah?
Not anyone is saving Ryulu, no, you are. Oh.
No, yeah, now I would have been in with such a crash by someone else.
Oh, really?
Well, it's still 2 knockouts, of course. But you're safe. Ryulu is again pretty far behind, actually. But he is still in. He is third last. Now it's very safe. 2 guys crashed hard.
Yeah, there's the people crashing left and right.
Like, I had such an understeer in the first drift. I don't know where that came from. I thought, like, yeah, come on, you have to keep now on the speed. You can't release now at the exit. And then I just jumped in that S corner. Like, I jumped so far that I didn't even make it in front of the wall to the left. I don't know why. As if my car didn't steer 100%. It was so weird. I thought, like, it can't be that I don't get the corner like that. Impossible.
Yeah, well, shit happens, right? Oh.
Well, there are 2 crashes already. 2 players a bit behind. And Ryulu is again third last. Ryulu is again third last. And again, 2 players actually made the mistake behind him.
LOL! I got a mid-road.
Oh, novice! It's novice versus Racer, and Racer is through. Novice fucked it up. But no, it's just 1 KO now.
Lol. Yeah,
man, novice so lucky.
At the transition, I got it like, yeah, okay, whatever. Nothing big happened. Well, what am I saying? Nothing big happened. I'm pretty close to getting out as well because of that. my left back wheel got lifted up from the transition jump at the end. Approaching the end.
Ah.
From the platform back to road. Just mid-road bug. Oh, what's this map again?
With a pole.
Yeah, nice. Thanks for telling me the last pole. This is actually pretty tight.
Yeah, 2 players already a bit behind there. With touches. Half a second or something behind the field. The one is now more. Nah, the last player is now far behind.
Yeah, that's how you take the end. Wow. Wow! Yeah, we got map.
this one I struggled so much.
Can I get second in the last series?
Yeah, I mean, it's really risky what you do.
That's like the worst thing you can even try to get, right? I mean, that means you're in the final. If you're in the final, you at least want to win that one.
I have so many first and second places in the last 2 weeks. I mean, many second places especially. Oh god, this guy is driving like me.
This guy?
Like, he's so far behind, he's already 8 tenths behind here. And the lines really look like my lines. But he's in.
Down.
He's in, because Dragon made a mistake.
How dare he?
And Spam also fell back, but still ahead of Yonix.
Like, really close and I'm behind, but in the like last couple of turns everyone is doing it even worse than I am. I mean, I'm catching up there, but I'm not really doing it good, so, well, I don't know.
Why do I don't have a camera here? This bugged game.
Yeah. I like your wording on that. Definitely a bugged game. It's not a bug in the game, it's a bugged game.
No slide now for Yonix.
Always Neo sliding this turn. That was good. Holy shit, the landing also was nice.
Miulu was again in danger. Oh, Spam is in danger, Spam is on last. Yonix versus Spam, Spam is through.
Oh. Oh. Yeah, war.
Spam crashed in
Holy
the end.
Shit. That was close.
He's really also having problems with this track, and the same goes for Riulu. They are actually the two players with the worst best time since map switch.
Oh well.
Spam crashed.
Who crashed? Spam?
Yeah. He crashed, but he is not last, I think. Is he? Ah, I don't see anyone else. Then he is last. But it showed me 13th in the CPs. That's why
I
wonder.
Yes! It took me way too long, but I won a round at least. 2 hours later. Holy shit. Well, almost 2 hours later.
Well, yeah, it showed number players 14 and now it shows number players 13. But this was already 13 when it showed 14. So now it's 12 and not 13. Also weird.
Whatever, right?
Yeah.
We're gonna have to figure it out after this. You can see at least it's still running and not. And maybe it might cause some problems in the end, but we see it.
Riulu. Now he's again behind, but nah, of course there comes the nose slide, obviously. Oh, Riulu with a mistake, Riulu with a mistake, and he gets overtaken by Carl. Super Carl oof. Oh my god, it's super close, Riulu has the chance to overtake not in the last corner. Ah, he overtakes two players actually, not and Summer who crashed, insane.
Insane. Ah.
How is Riulu actually only 0.8 behind? I don't get that one. How is he only point? He had a full crash, like, and he also had a full release in the beginning, which put him already into the last position. How is this only 0.8? I don't get it.
I'm trying to whisper something. Oh no! Okay. I don't know what to do on this map actually at the start because yeah,
I just go middle pole.
No, you're gonna tell me how bad it is. How bad is it? What are the other ones doing?
Yeah, if you were going right, if you were going middle, but you are in the fifth place in the top positions.
Oh, I forgot this. I actually forgot this turn. Wow.
And then no hairpin.
Yeah, well. That would've. Oh, Giordano.
Oh god, Not who just was lucky to survive, he is 10 seconds behind. He's oh, wow. So alone. Holy shit.
Take that earlier then. Don't make me struggle. If someone is 10 seconds behind.
I didn't know before.
So what is the majority of people doing? Are they going inside at the very start? No, right?
It was 50-50. Hey, have a look at it with free cam now.
I'm gonna try it in between poles now as well. Come on, Shorty.
Just come just from a bit more left in the start.
Yeah, yeah.
And then around
just a little bit more left, and then here, and...
Yeah, one guy crashed. And you are at the like end really? Of the field. Yeah, one guy crashed. He's behind. The second.
Yeah, but I think the other way, I was faster the other way, probably.
Yeah, yeah, you, position-wise, you were better there.
Yeah. Well, position-wise is not relevant, but time loss.
Oh, yeah, it's not the hint
I'm
for me.
I'm always a Giordano in this turn now. Someone crashed, right? And not us, right?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. This might be a little bit difficult. Oh! Oh well. Look way closer in the scoreboard on the left than 1 second. Plopped up immediately. Ah. Why am I so bad at this?
I was also bad on this. Oh, I think that was a mistake. It was a Thompson? I guess it's not Thompson though. Razor is last.
You know, the more I want to be happy about people crashing at the start, the more I know it. One time they don't, I'm last. So, not sure if I can be happy. I feel so special. Who's that?
Cabby.
Okay.
What is this horn?
It felt like somebody made a mistake again.
Let me check. Nah, not really, it's still quite close there.
Oh.
Yannix and Cabby are the last ones. Cabby now crashed. Went yeah. To white. He went to white at the exit of the hairpin.
Yes! Not sure if I should be happy, but I am. Ah, one more round.
Nice car skin, Shorty, lul.
Thank you. Well, thanks anyway, even though I didn't make it. But I love it.
Oh, someone crashed into the pole. Yeah, and is one of the favorites. And he's probably now out.
Just say his name!
Novice. Riolu! Riolu made a mistake, but he's still ahead of Novice. Oh my god, how lucky can you actually be? But maybe Novice can pull it off still. Who knows? Yeah, he can. Riolu with another mistake. I mean, if Riolu is now not out, I don't know.
Oh, wait for it. I can crash the ending if you want. I let me slow down a little bit in the ending in case there's the nation by Rudo. No. That's bound to be happen. It was about to be happened, right? Ah.
Yeah, his first mistake looked really weird. He got shabated there. But the second was a no slide.
Look what Virgil wrote. I'm the player now. Oh, I like that.
Yeah. And Ryu, do max the managing.
I don't even know if I'm good on this map, to be honest. I don't think I am. At least I'm not fast. But at least the song is nice.
Definitely an interesting lineup here. Currently Thompson in last place. Also doesn't have the best approach there, but saved himself through. You are pretty good position wise, Shorty. Oh, Yannick with a mistake from second to last now. Yeah, this is it for Yannick. Like you had such a different line to everyone else there in the last corner.
I don't think it makes sense to go to the far outside. I mean, I stayed ahead of Bergie, so... Oh, whatever. That's not gonna be decisive, I guess. Oh. If it is, I hope it's decisive in my favor.
This was a bad line for Thompson. He's now half a second behind.
Half a second is nice.
Yeah, it looks even more. Like, from the looks, it's so much that, yeah, no chance for him to come back now.
Yo, what happened in the last turn? Oh, okay.
Okay, a top 4 situation now. Veterans Berkey and Shorty versus Aegir and Novice. Novice, of course,
oh my God,
the fastest win.
Okay.
But he was so lucky that he's still in.
Someone has to be lucky.
And Iggy with a no slide.
Big one?
Yeah. Next round you have to work on your end.
Well, big one. Well, 0.7 is not that big, but okay. Yeah, I guess it's big.
Next round you have to work on your ending.
Yeah, do I?
Yeah.
Not the last turn, but the ending before, right?
Yeah, yeah, before. Novice had a weird line there.
Oh, you're down.
You're still ahead of Turkey? Now side by side.
Yeah, just say if he crashes.
Good last turn you need. Ah, damn it. What is Novice doing every single round he crashes at the end? Like, and Berkey is again in the final.
Yeah, I had to release like crazy in the second to last turn because I went a little bit. Why?
You let him through, you didn't want to get second.
That's actually true. No, that's the other way around. If I would have made this one, I would have won.
Oh. It's still a bit weird how Berkey survived until the final because. Speed-wise, he seemed to be a bit behind.
No, I don't think so. I saw him at the top quite frequently. To
yeah, yeah, but the first half of the map, he was always behind. He had a good ending.
Ah, okay. Yeah, I mean...
all hotkeys on Novice, obviously. Anti crashes now.
No
I need to.
No way! Come on, no. Whatever.
Yeah, it's so gifted.
Oh. Ah.
Okay, you would have won, I guess. I mean, on the other hand, Novice didn't deserve to win. You were so lucky to be in.
Yeah, I guess Birgit did deserve to win, to be honest.
Ah, he plays the Mario's way. Doesn't make many mistakes.
Could I say something like, yeah, I'm not deserve win, yeah, easy, did nobody even try? Am I supposed to do that? I guess not, right?
No, better not.
Maybe if it would have been spam instead of Birgit, maybe I could have done it then. But not when Birgit wins.
I mean, Birgit didn't make mistakes, was alright.
Yeah, it was really solid from him. I mean, he never made any mistakes. Like, nothing I can remember.
But speed-wise, he... I'm not sure, they were faster ones. He was lucky that people crashed out that would have beaten him.
Yeah, but I think speed-wise he was exactly where he should be in the TTC. Yeah. Like, he was at the top, but he wasn't like the best. But that's exactly where you want to be, right?
Oh, yeah.
He was able to drive really good times where you could, like, where you would get second or third in a round, and that's exactly what you need. You don't need to get first like Novice all the time, because somewhere you're gonna make a mistake at some point. At least if you push it like 100% all the time. So, I don't know. I mean, it worked for Birgit anyway, right? Could have also worked for Novus, but at least from a personal point of view, I like how the way Birgit played the TTC. Oh well.
So now plugin, now the plugin should be sure that he is a winner.
Hopefully.
Initiating final round, what? okay. Well, I could have survived a bit longer today, but I was really unfocused, and I have these days where it's like, I just want to, I don't know, watch movies, do nothing.
Yeah, but then why? I mean, you don't even have to play TTC.
But the thing is, I already did yesterday nothing. Like, yesterday ended up with an early shift, today I had a middle shift, so I had pretty much free time in between. What did I do after the early shift? I was sleeping until I went into cinema with Lars, and after I came back from the cinema, I was sleeping again. That was everything.